How's it going, guys? Long story short, I counted the cost of a fart. I made the purchase, turned out to be more than I bargained for. My underwear is over there. It smells bad in here, so evidently I've got some stuff that I have to do. So let's have a quick abbreviated version of what the heck I was about to say. A production company called Crackle, who was making a Dead Rising movie, used my signature saw blade Battleaxe design. That's pretty cool, only they didn't give me any credit. Kinda sucks, but it's fine, I'm over it. Please, for the love of gosh, do not go to their video and thumb it down and leave mean comments and stuff. We're Zednauts. We have honor, even if we poop in our pants sometimes. So instead of taking the opportunity to get all mad and stuff, I decided to take it instead to work on my designs. And so in the end, I have come up with the double-bladed saw blade Battleaxe that I'm calling the Vulture. I like it a whole lot better. I think you guys also probably will too. Basically, it's twice as much of what is good about the old one and half as much of what is bad about it, meaning there are twice as many sides with blades on it and half. Well, it's not really half. They're okay. There's negative infinity what is bad about the last one, because half zero is. Here's the build. I hope you guys enjoy the video. Oh, and please, 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 please go to teespring.com/alpha-quantum. Buy yourself a hoodie or a t-shirt. It really, really helps me out. And also, you guys can enter into a contest once you do that to get the Nuka-Cola Quantum, the official one from the Fallout 4 release. All those years ago, way back in the day. I'm sorry. Here you go. Here's the build. So as always, we're starting with a hickory replacement axe handle. But since this is a double-bladed axe, you're going to get the axe handle that is for double-bladed axes. The difference is that it is symmetrical on both sides. Before we start attaching stuff to it, I'm gonna use this little cloth in my vise to make sure that it doesn't damage the handle, and I'm gonna clamp up the handle and use this 2-minute varnish remover and the crappiest draw knife of all time to remove the poly coat from the handle so that once we got all the pieces together, we can stain the handle and just put everything together really quick. So now that that's finished, we're going to prepare the saw blade. You're gonna want to look at the back chart right here underneath where it says choices, la lame, skill, qui, convenient. About 5 lines down, in French again, it says that this is good for saw blade battle axes, so this is the one that you want. Gonna use some more of that varnish remover to get rid of this hoopla. All right, we're gonna set this aside and then we're going to cut this in half with an angle grinder. Now we do a little flippy, and we're gonna cut 1, 2, 3 teeth off to the center. Now I'll measure out a little piece of steel. Ow, that's hot. Now I'm going to do a couple little tack welds to hold everything nice and straight before I fully weld everything together. Now I gotta flatten this out. I'm gonna use a flap disc for this. This is the same thing that I used to clean the mill scale off of this middle piece of steel. Alright, not a great weld, but lucky this is not doing any load bearing. This weld is just to keep these two blades aligned with each other when we start running straps across. Now we're gonna widen the slot a little bit so that we can fit this in here without splitting the wood. Now I finally figured out how to use my bandsaw correctly, so I'm gonna use this, but in the off chance you don't have a 14-inch bandsaw, a hacksaw or a handsaw are gonna do the exact same thing. It's just gonna take a little bit longer. Got a couple of machetes here. I'm going to remove the handles real quick. Then I put the machete blade here and I mark on the top and bottom where I'm gonna cut. Now this is all I got for this stuff. I know if I start making the straps for this thing out of this, I'm gonna run out and I have to go back to the store. So instead of doing that, I'm gonna make my own straps out of this leftover tread plate from my armor build. And I'm thinking it might even end up looking cooler than it would have with the other stuff. So now with all the straps cut out, I can finally get to work staining this here handle. I'm gonna start this with some pre-stain. That sit for a minute, then after about 15 minutes, we apply the stain. Now leave that to set for about another 15 minutes. Clear it off. Hey, not even an iDubbbz reference. It looks pretty good. I'm gonna pull this off so I can get a better angle on it. Push this out of the way. Leave it to dry.
All right, I think my microphone got unplugged or something. One way or another, I lost all the audio for this clip, but it's fine. All I was really saying in the video was that I was having some trouble aligning the top and the bottom of the blade inside the handle. So I just did my regular thing where I drill through it. I put a 20D nail through it. I trim it off at about 2 millimeters. Then I put the end on a solid metal surface like a vise or a dumbbell or something like that. And then I use a ball peen hammer to mushroom out the end of the nail so it's fixed in there permanently. So then once we do this, then the nail sort of acts as a pivot so you can adjust the bottom of the blade without it messing up the top.
All right, this side's further out than this side, so we just give a few taps here. Don't worry about chipping the tooth. When we sharpen the saw blade, it's gonna get chipped anyways. Good. Put another rivet down here to keep everything straight. And once that's there, I'm gonna clamp this piece of wood to this saw blade. I'm going to put the machete right here, leaving a very small gap so I can get my weld in there. Clamp this right here. And similar to last time, do a little spot weld here, remove all the stuff, and then do the rest of the weld. All right, be super careful about how hot this is getting because you don't want to burn the wood too bad. Now I'm gonna try something I never tried before. First of all, I'm using the scraps from the throwing stars as the reinforcement brackets, but that's not really relevant. What I'm gonna try, instead of messing around with, you know, 50 clamps all over the thing, trying to hold everything together while I drill through, is I'm just gonna do a few welds right here, and hopefully that should hold everything together well enough that I'll be able to drill through it, everything will stay together, and my life will be a million times easier. Hopefully. Let's try it. Enough to be able to fit it inside the vise. Squeeze this down to form the bracket around the wood. I'm gonna do this one just because it would bug me if I didn't. This table's getting pretty rough, huh? All right, just to show you guys really quick how I do the straps, all I did was drill through here, I bent it at 1 inch, then I put it right here, and I use a Sharpie to mark out in the hole where I have to drill through the machete. I do that, and then I bring the other strap in here, and I put them both on both sides here, and I pop a rivet through there. And as you saw, I use the vise to bend it around here, I clamp it down, drill through it, pop the next rivet. For the final paint job, I'll put a rough edge on all these teeth. Now tape up all the wood and the bevels and give it its final paint job. And that's how you get over someone stealing your idea. If you guys haven't figured it out, I film my intros and my outros at the same time, so the poo is still over there just watching me. But that's fine, because that's all I got for today, except for please buy a hoodie or a t-shirt. Thank you all very much for watching. I'll talk to you later. Bye.